It's my pleasure to be a part of Nojoto to start with. My name is Kartikey Sharma. I'm a very ordinary person. I had a very ordinary Navy child life till I reached a stage where I first started discovering a different part of me. I was a very usual student. I was good at academics, I was good at sports. I was even the house captain of my in my school. And a very active, normal person who had nothing, no big desires, no big dreams, just a very good routine, and I was very fit. But in 2009, when I was just joining my 12th standard, I got diagnosed with cancer the first time, and that's when my perspective towards life changed a little. I had never read a single book before that, but after that I started reading books. I started watching movies. Actually, I had not watched a lot of movies before. And my perspective towards life improved, and the whole year which I was in the hospital, I happened to learn a lot of things, a lot of different things. Since I was a child, I used to wait till the exams used to get over, and then I used to sketch or make a painting. I was very familiar with crayons. I remember I always used to make a crayon. No matter what the situation of my life has been, as an artist, I have discovered myself better every time. There have been times of monotonous, same kind of art and same kind of routine, but luckily, my life has given me a lot of chances to rediscover myself with all the diseases and hurdles in life. Not just about myself, but about art, about other things. But it's a fun life to explore, and that's what I'm doing. A very, very long life. Every day when you get up, you should be wanting to live that day. A person should be wanting to go to his work, go to the place of worship. Work is worship. Go to that place, explore himself, explore his ideas, explore his creativity. In no matter what field you are in, even if you are a doctor, when you get up in the morning, you should feel like going to your patient, helping him out, learning new things about the disease, learning new things about curing the disease. The zeal, the interest, the motivation comes when you follow your passion. If you are passionate about coding, you will get up in the morning, think of a very new idea every day, make an app fail, make fail, make fail, and one day you will create something which you wouldn't have even imagined. Same way, I'm an artist. So my passion is to paint or to express, to make. So every morning when I get up, I try to think of what is inside me and how I can put it on paper. Because it's a very long life, and if you want to live it happily with satisfaction, you need to do what you love. And following passion doesn't mean ki mujhe music pasand hai, aaj se main sirf guitar bajaunga. No. You know what you're good at, you know what your interests are, you develop those interests. You start developing yourself on them, you start working on them, and slowly, slowly you keep picking up more interesting stuff and you develop. It's a procedure, it happens every day and continuously. It does not happen overnight. So if you're following your passion, in any field it may be, you'll be happy. Because you have to live a long life with that work, and you better be doing what you love. I started, when I decided I want to become a professional artist, I started with a canvas, of course, to practice and also to sell. But I realized that it is not very easy to get audience for a canvas. And at that time, I used to paint walls at school, at college, for college festivals. I realized this at least gets me a lot of coverage, a lot of people see it, no matter from where they are. When you are making a canvas, it goes into a gallery. A very specific people who can afford to go to a gallery, who are from that class, see it. But art is for everybody. My intention was to get that gallery out and put it on the wall so that money will come eventually. But people need to see what you are thinking, people need to see what you are working on. I wanted that appreciation, I wanted that criticism, I wanted people to, more and more people to see it, and that's why I chose graffiti, because it is loud, it is in the public, people see it, and that's the best money or the best price an artist can get is viewership, and that's what I wanted, and that's why I went for graffiti. I've been doing art for a while, professionally also, but last year I made a painting when I had come home from the hospital. It took me a week. That day my father said that he liked it. He said this is something very interesting, and finally it feels like you can be an actual painter. So that was the best feedback I ever got, and I think I always want feedbacks from my parents. Especially my dad is very hard to please, or maybe he always has kept standards high for me. So when he said that, हाँ अब लग रहा है कि तू painter है, ये painting जैसी लग रही है. That was my favorite feedback in the best moment. There was a long period in the last year when nothing was working for me. All my chemotherapies failed, my cancer was increasing aggressively. But one day, some doctor gave me the solution. My father, he's the best. He somehow managed to get me that medicine from abroad and somehow managed to save my life. First time we saw one single positive result out of my long months of around 9 months of failures of 12 chemotherapies. First sign of development when we saw that yes, there is a chance to live. That's when I made this painting. It's a set of open doors and the stairs are climbing to an open sky. This was my representation of my feeling that the doors have finally opened and I have some hope. This is hope for me. The open doors behind me is my home. Everything is art, honestly speaking. Art is when you give a part of yourself to the work you are doing. So my message to everybody is, know what you like, know what you're good at, develop those skills and do it every day. Make it your life.